Now to a story that might explain the sorry state of our roads. The O'Farrell Government has hit a major pothole with claims it has underspent on maintenance by a staggering $1 billion. And in a fumbled explanation, it disputed the figure, then once again blamed a budget error for it. Josh Murphy has this exclusive report.
Not hard to find a rough ride in Sydney. This cracked and broken surface is in St Peter's, and believe it or not, it's named Rickety Street. Rickety by name and nature.
How do you rate the roads around here as a truck?
Pretty poor.
And according to budget papers, it's little wonder. Almost $2 billion was allocated to fix roads last financial year, but the figures show just over $1 billion's been spent, leaving a hole of $960 million kept in the bank.
This is a government that has come into power saying they're going to improve roads right across New South Wales.
Considering all the taxes they take out of your licence fees, etc., your registration, yeah, it's pretty ordinary.
While there still is plenty of road work going on, the opposition claims that the scale of the backlog needs to be rectified by the Roads Minister because it's costing drivers more than just an uncomfortable commute. One authorised pink slip mechanic has told us most of the 10 or so cars he checks daily need repair.
A majority of about, say, 5, 6 out of the 10 do have suspension damage.
But late today, the state government denied the $900 million underspend and, incredibly, blamed a typo, claiming instead $160 million was the amount left over. Just last month, the Auditor-General slammed the government for losing $1 billion.
The budget result bounced around a bit like a pinball machine.
Now it seems like another billion has been misplaced, this time left on the side of the road. Josh Murphy, 10 News.